If you just looked at food on the shelves of a grocery store, you might forget that the food we eat is part of a natural system. Any food begins with soil, and soil may include compost, manure, or other fertilizers. Because farms are part of the natural world, animals wander in and leave excrement, whether it's a feral hog, deer, a flock of birds, or lizards from the ditch. People also may use the restroom in unauthorized places. Because of this, the soil may be contaminated with pathogens, tiny microbes that make people sick. When we irrigate or when it rains, water spreads those microbes from one source to another. Runoff from adjacent pastures can also be an issue. By the time of harvest, produce may have been exposed to pathogens from the soil. When it's picked by a worker or a machine, more pathogens may be added. Hands or equipment can be sources of contamination. If containers haven't been properly cleaned and sanitized and carefully stored, they may also harbor pathogens. By the time fruit leaves the field, it is possibly contaminated with microbes from several sources. After harvest, fruit is taken from the field to the pack shed. The result is a container full of the things we want and occasionally some of the things we don't. So, how can you avoid sending contamination to the pack shed? Do what you can to discourage animals from entering. If practical, fence around fields to limit animal access. Sometimes circumstances are beyond your control. So, encourage employees to report animal activity and don't pick produce that has been visibly contaminated by animals. When irrigating, spraying water for frost control or spraying pesticide, use a clean water source. Provide restroom and hand washing stations for your employees. And clean all equipment regularly. The field is the first line of defense. What you do here impacts the health and safety of consumers.